Welcome to our few moments together on the Parsha. This Shabbos, we have the privilege of reading Parshas Beshalach. Parshas Beshalach, of course, is known for the Shira, the song that the Jewish people sang at the Yam Suf after being rescued by the miraculous splitting of the Reed Sea, the Yam Suf. If you take a look at the Parsha itself is divided in two main sections. Although there are 116 psukim in the Parsha, 59 at the beginning of the Parsha speak about the going out of Egypt and the miraculous splitting of the Yam Suf. The last 57, just about half, almost exactly equal, speak about the need of the Jewish people for water and food in the form of the miraculous rock that Moshe was told to hit in this week's Edra, and which he does, and brings forth water, and the coming down of the Mun, and the various special laws about the Mun, some of which we observe in various ways today, such as the covering of the challah, two of them, because a double portion fell on Friday, and we put a covering on top, and there's a covering on the bottom, just like the Mun. But the day that we read Parshas Beshalach this year is not only the reading of Parshas Beshalach, it's also Tu Bishvat. And as the Gemara in Rosh Hashanah tells us, it is the new year of the trees. According to Beis Hillel, that falls on the 15th day in the month of Shvat. Now, the two main themes of this week's Sedra, on the one hand, the Shira, on the other hand, the need for sustenance, and the fact that they are almost exactly equal in terms of psukim, tell us that in many ways they're both equal. The miraculous splitting of the Yam Suf has its parallel in the miraculous provision of food and sustenance for mankind, and the digestion of the food by mankind. The miraculous eating with flavors. You know, Hashem could have made it that we be, I suppose, like a car, that somewhere in our head we had a gauge where, when it was time to eat, the gauge would be going towards empty. And as we got to the E, we would know it was time to open our mouths, put in a nozzle, press the button, and fill up, just like a car. No taste, no flavor, no diversity, no color, none of the great gifts that come along with food. Food and the provision of food, the digestion of food, the entire institution, and the way our bodies so perfectly absorb the nutrients and expectorate that which is unnecessary and harmful. A great miracle, even equal to the splitting of the Yam Suf. And so, the Shira that we say this week is half of the Sedra, the eating of bread and food, and a reminder that the Birchas HaMazon was authored in the first paragraph by none other than Moshe Rabbeinu on the advent of the Mun. And it's Kili Olam Chasdo, next to the last Kili Olam Chasdo of the 26 that are listed in that paragraph that we say each Shabbos morning. In there is the splitting of the Yam Suf. But right before the end comes the greatest of all miracles. No sein lechem l'chol basar kili olam chasdo. He gives sustenance to all flesh, for his kindness is forever. On Tu Bishvat, when we eat the new fruits of the land of Israel, when we eat of the seven species that are mentioned in Perich Ches and Pasach Ches, in Devarim, Eretz Chita Us Ora, Gefen Te'ena Verimon, Eretz Eishemen Udvash, when we speak about the wheat and the barley and the vine and the fig and the pomegranate and the olive and the honey of dates, when we speak about those seven species, we're speaking about a miraculous system whereby it is no less important to us than the actual splitting of the Red Sea. It's as great a miracle as the Parsha seems to parallel the two and juxtapose them one against the other. When we eat that new fruit, symbolic of the bringing of the first fruits at the time of the Beis HaMikdash, let's contemplate. Wow, what a delicious date. What a delicious fruit that Hashem gave us to help us to live. And that the land of Israel is celebrated for this great fruit. And it's no less a miracle than the splitting of the Red Sea on which songs are sung. Because no same lechem l'chol basar ki li'olam chasdo. Let's enjoy that shehechianu, that new fruit, that opportunity to thank Hashem for giving us the gift of the new fruits and the gift of the Jewish people that have not forgotten the miraculous nature of our existence, thanks to the Shira at the splitting of the Red Sea. Have a wonderful Shabbos.